Hello everyone, my name is Shafin from Grade 8 from Tala Padmavati International School, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh. First of all, I wish you all a happy Sankrant. We celebrate Sankrant with absolute grandeur, traditional songs and dance performances. And morning we do Surya Puja, at evening all of them carry a golden palanquin of God Surya and is taken across all the city along the decorated camels and elephants. Further, all the ladies beautifully themselves with henna, vermilions, bindi. And today we make all the sweet, delicious Rajasthani dishes like pinni, either with sugar syrup or sweet milk dipped, and gajak, tilpatti, tilladu. On this blessed day, we also bathe in Indian rivers like Ganga and Yamuna. And we also donate the utensils to the married women to get charity. On this Sankranti day, we also exchange the jaggery and til. We celebrate this blessed day by flying kites on our rooftop and allow the people on the competition of kite flying. And I also love to keep Rangoli with my mother. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Happy Uttarayani. Oh, you might be wondering what Uttarayani is, right? In Uttarakhand, we call your Sankranti festival as Uttarayani. We have a reason for that. Do you know what it is? Okay, I'll tell you about it. And I'll also tell you about our celebrations of Uttarayani. Usually, from this day of the festival, the sun becomes Uttarayan, means it starts moving to the north. So this is why we call this festival as Uttarayan. And we also believe that the migratory birds start coming back to the hills, which signifies a change of season. During this festival, we offer khichdi in charity and take ceremonial dip in the holy river. We also participate in Uttarayani fair. Gur, which is called Jagri, leads a main role. We seek blessings from our elders and in return, we give Jagri to them. This denotes that all the bitterness between us gets vanished. And we make a sweet called Kubute, made with wheat flour and Jagri. Then, we offer them to crows. The child who feeds the crow first is considered to be lucky. We feed crows with Kubutis, believing that it means to pay homage to the departed souls of our ancestors. Once there lived a Chan king named Raja Kailan. He was childless and once he was blessed by Lord Shiva. Soon after, he had a son who was affectionately called as Gugutia. He always wore a pearl necklace that he was very fond of. So this is the reason for the children wearing Gugutia garlands in Uttarakhand. As per the legend, Sankranti killed a devil called Sankarasan. This is the history behind our festival. During the festival, we really have a joyful mood. We sing and dance to enjoy the day. One will definitely enjoy Uttarayani in our state, just like in other states. But still, ours is a way different from others. Our eyes will be filled with the reflections of the cultural fairs, holy rivers, dances, food, birds, happiness, rituals, and what else is left to be seen in a great festival. Once again, I wish you all a very happy Uttarayani. Enjoy this festive day with your family and friends. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Amanda of grade 7 from Tala Padmavati International School. Today I'm going to say how the people of West Bengal celebrate Sankranti. They call Sankranti as Posh Sankranti. The freshly harvested paddy and date plant syrup in the form of khajur, gur and pathali is used in preparation of sweet. Prayers, bathing in the river and feast are important part of the festival celebrations. During family reunions, there is exchange of sweets and fruits and a ritual belief to multiple the season's producer. Thank you and I wish you a happy Sankranti.
Hello everyone, I'm Navina. Do you know friends that Sankranti is the only festival which is celebrated almost overall India. So now let's see how do we celebrate Sankranti in Odisha. Namaskar, Mora naam Navina. Makara Sankranti Shubhakam Naik. We call Sankranti in Oriya language as Makara Sankranti. The special dish made during this Sankranti is Makara Chavla. We use uncooked rice, banana, coconut, jaggery sesame, rasgulla, chenna puddings and feed it to the gods or goddesses. And then we worship sun god in Konark temple. As it starts, it swings towards north. And then we do holy bath and attend Makara Mela and participate in it. Thank you everyone. Have a safe and a beautiful Sankranti. Makara Sankranti Shubhakam Naik.
Sarvana Namaskar. Tumhe sage kaisa hai? Main chhan hai. Aaj mein Maharashtra Sankranti. Kaisi kaha to? Tumhara Sankranti attend hai. Hello everyone, how are you all? I'm fine. Today I'm here to explain you about how we celebrate Sankranti in Maharashtra. Tilkul Gheva Gol Gol Bola. Accept this Tilkul and offer sweet goods. Tilkul is made of jaggery and sesame seeds. Another story Maharashtrians believe, Lord Surya forgave his son Shani and his son visited him on Sankranti. And ask them to let go of any negative or angry feeling.
Hi everyone, myself is Sri Haspit from 6th grade Tala Padmavati International School. Today I am going to say how they will celebrate Sankranti in Andhra Pradesh. Makara Sankranti is a festival day in Hindu's calendar. Dedicated to the sun. It falls on January 15, the beginning of an auspicious phase in Indian culture. It is celebrated for 3 days. First day is named Bhogi, second day is named Sankranti, third day is named Kanuma. Sankranti is also celebrated the harvesting festival and marks the arrival of spring. They will fly kites too. In Andhra Pradesh, Makara Sankranti is also called Pedda Panduga. They also fry Bhogi Mantalu on Bhogi. In all over India, Sankranti is mostly celebrated in Andhra Pradesh. I wish you very happy Sankranti to all. Thank you everyone.
Hello everyone, I am Sara Samin from grade 7 from Tala Padmavati International School. Today I am going to show you a festival which is celebrated mostly in Punjab, that is Lohri. Lohri is a festival which is celebrated in Punjab. It is believed by many that the festival commemorates the passing of the winter solstice. Lohri marks the end of the winter and is a traditional welcome of longer days and the sun's journey to the northern hemisphere by Sikhs and Hindus in the Punjab region of the Indian subcontinent. In Punjab, the harvest festival Lohri is marked by eating sheaves of roasted corn from the new harvest. The January sugarcane harvest is celebrated in the Lohri festival. It is also traditional to eat til rice, which is made by mixing jaggery, sesame seeds and rice. In some places, this dish is called Tricholi. And the foods which are served in the Lohri celebrations are sarson ka saag, makki ki roti, aata laddu and a kheer, which is prepared by rice, milk and juice. And The Punjab people believe that bathing in holy water and lighting lamps with sesame oil brings prosperity and drive all the sins. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hi everyone. I'm Sanam Joshi. I'm studying seventh grade. I'm from Haryana and Delhi. We celebrate Sankrant in very different manner. We celebrate Sankrant in holy dip in the river. The special dishes prepared on this occasion are kheer, churma, halwa, laddus, which is known as chikkis, and also tilgur, which is prepared by sesame and jaggery. We believe that brothers of married women visit their home with a gift bag called sindhara of wood and warm clothes to her and her husband's family. Thank you. Hope you like this.
My name is Manha Payar from grade 7. Today I am going to tell you how the people of Uttar Pradesh celebrate Sankranti. They call Sankranti as Kichhil. First they have a ritual bath and then they prepare the special dish of the day, that is Kichhil. And they prepare many sweets like laddu, good laddu, and they start this festival Kichhil with Maha Kumbh Mela, kite flying, and they sing songs like Meethe Gudu Me Mil Gaya Dil, Udi Patang Aur Khil Gaya Dil, Jeevan Ke Rekha Me Ho Jaye Sukh Aur Shanti, Mubarak Ho Aapko Makar Sankranti. Happy Sankranti. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Shivapriya from grade 7. Now I am going to say you how the people of Tamil Nadu celebrate the festival Sankranti. Sankranti is celebrated differently in the Indian subcontinent. Many Hindus have a holy bath in the river Ganga and pray to the god Sun. Now let us know how the people of Tamil Nadu celebrate this festival. People of Tamil Nadu call Sankranti as Pongal. Pongal is the most important and popular festival of Tamil Nadu. It is also called as a harvest festival. People of Tamil Nadu believe that New Year starts with this festival. They celebrate this festival for 4 days. Those are Bodhi Pongal, Surya Pongal, Nat Pongal and Kanma Pongal. They celebrate this festival on the month of January from 13th to 16th. They prepare a special dish on this festival also. That is Van Pongal. They prepare this with cashew nuts, cumin seeds, ginger, crushed pepper, turmeric and ghee. So this is all about how the people of Tamil Nadu celebrate the festival. Thank you.
Hi everyone, this is Ashni from Tala Padmavati International School. First, I wish everyone happy Sankranti to everyone. Let us know about the Gujarati state celebrate Sankranti festival. In Gujarati, Sankranti is called as Uttarayan. 14th Jan, they celebrate Uttarayan. And 15th Jan, they celebrate Vasi Uttarayan. And on this day, they prepare a special dish known as Undayu, which is spices bagged with mixture of winter vegetables and chickpeas, made a sea salmon, jaggeries and peanuts. Flying kites is a major celebration of Gujarati. And when the kites are cut, the younger boy says, "Kai konche, lapet, jay jay." Firket wet firket, lapet lapet, which means catching the kite, whack, spin and whack and bite. Once again, happy Sankranti to everyone. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Akshya. I'm studying in 6th standard from Tala Padmavati International School. Today I'm going to say the importance of Makara Sankranti, how they're celebrating Karnataka. They throw old clothes from their home and they clean their home and whitewash their walls and they decorate the bulls, colorfully and beautifully. They burn the old wood and elubella tindu olaimatali, meaning eat elubella and talk good. Thank you.
And my dear teachers, I am Arjun from 6th grade Paris Gardner. Today I'm going to say how Jharkhand people celebrate Makara Sankranti. There is a saying in Jharkhand that 12 months 13 festivals, all festivals are related to nature and agriculture. In Jharkhand, Makara Sankranti is called Tusu Festival. It is a harvest festival. This festival runs from Agan Paunami to Posh Paunami. This festival is mainly about the collection of songs sung by the unmarried girls during nights throughout the month of Posh. The main components of this festival are paddy and rice. They prepare khichdi on Tusu. Thank you. Jharkhand style khichdi is ready. I wish you a happy Sankranti.
Friends and my teachers, I am Arun from Grade 8 DPS Varangal. Today I want to say the celebration of Makar Sankranti in Bihar. In Bihar, Makar Sankranti is called Mahalakshmi Puja. The festival is celebrated on 14th-15th January. On 14th January, it is celebrated as Makar Sankranti or Khichdi. Bihar people took a dip in the holy Ganga and other rivers on Tuesday to mark the annual harvest festival of Makar Sankranti. People enjoy the festivities like Chura Dahi, Tilkot, Khichdi and Gur. Chura Dahi is a staple dish in Bihar during Makar Sankranti. Chura Dahi is ready. Happy Makar Sankranti. Happy Chura Dahi. Thank you.